والله فيري من
الاسكيل شديد بيوتيفول
فيري 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 بعدين التغيير بتاع
العالم بس وفر على بيوتيفول
بالليل بالليل كده يعني بالليل انا طيارة
I make a film because there's just beside with all.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are coming towards Romani Fortress. The fortress on the European side, it is called Romani Fortress, that was built at the year of 1452. It was a part of a project of conquer, of course, of the Romans. Right after successful capture of the city, the fortress was abandoned because it was lost its purposes. So it's abandoned over the centuries. In fact, it was used as a prison for a while. At the year of 1950.
Sekarang saya sedang berada di dalam satu perahu dengan mengikuti tur untuk Bosphorus dengan hidangan makannya ya, dan ada atraksi musik. Jadi kalau datang ke Istanbul ke Turki, kita bisa banyak mengikuti kegiatan-kegiatan tur salah satunya.
So when we are touring with tourists, we also say golden horizon. But actually we Turks we call this water as Halic. Halic, in fact, that's an Arabic word that entered the Turkish language that means estuary. What estuary is, because at the end of this water there is one river, that river was flowing into the sea because of erosion. The river brings its soil, its alluvials. So that soil accumulates at the sea and gradually it makes a couple of islands opposite by its shore. So it's a geographical term. So we Turks, we name this water with the name of its geographical formation. So both sides of the boat, either right or left side, are Europe because we are not at Bosphorus Channel yet. Now we are looking to the right side of the boat. This is Pera. Pera, also it's an ancient Greek language. It means others, other side. Because this side of the water of Ottoman at the time of Byzantium Empire, at the time of East Roman Empire, it was a colony of Genoa. It was a Genoese colony. So since Genoese people, they were Catholics, and the other side of the water, they were Orthodox. So Orthodox people named the other side as others. Relatively, the side of Pera is the newer part of the city that began to develop at 19th century. There are still Catholic population living at the side of Pera. It's about 35,000 people. They have their own churches like Santa Maria, San Antoine. In fact, San Antoine is a Roman Catholic church. It's close to Vatican. Mainly Orthodox churches are at Constantinople. The other side also, the Turks would call this area Kasım Pasha. Kasım Pasha, he was the great admiral at 16th century. At the time of Sultan Süleyman. So you see there is a still navy boats. And there's a one big building over there with the clock towers and the restoration like that. That's a command post of Turkish naval forces. Yes, as you see that building with towers is on the restoration over there.
Thank you.
Which means new mosque in Turkish, and it's the name of the mosque is new, that was built at the year of 1664. Now we're going to pass you under the Galata Bridge or front, which is the last bridge at the water of Golden Horn. There was always a bridge at this location since 6th centuries. They were building new bridges instead of the older ones. This is the last Galata Bridge that was built at the year of 1993 instead of the older one that was burnt off by fire at the year of 1992. Under the Galata Bridge, the area on the right side we are looking at, it is called Edirne. At the time of Ottoman Empire, there were customs offices because there was a harbor at this location. Today, Edirne is still one of the active business district, and there is a huge transportation hub for public boats. And one of the oldest temples is going to appear from the right side, ladies and gentlemen. We are looking at Hagia Sophia. Hagia Sophia was built at the year of 537. At the reign of East Roman Emperor Justinianus. It was an imperial church for East Roman Empire, for Orthodox Roman Empire, for this Roman Empire, for 981 years, after Istanbul was conquered by Ottoman Sultan Mehmed II. This imperial church was converted to imperial mosque, and was served as an imperial mosque for 470 years. Since 1935, it was a museum until recently. A couple of years ago, it was changed to a mosque. Yeah. side, that's Asia. So on the way back, we will follow the Asian shore, then we will come at the same place, but this time we're going to follow the European side, which is not Singapore. As you see on the European side, ladies and gentlemen, there are several new buildings. Some of them are open as additional passenger terminals from cruise ships. It is actually partly open. As you see, when we go further, you see there are pedestrians are walking on the shore. And besides of these passenger terminals, there are many other new buildings that are opened recently as shops, restaurants, cafes. You know, it's kind of like kind of popular shopping mall stuff. The name what? Of this area that we are passing from its front, it is called Galata Port, ladies and gentlemen. Now we are passing from front of Galata Port.
Galata Port. Wow. see the tank before.
I make a film because let's just decide.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are coming to Romani Fortress. The fortress on the European side, it is called Romani Fortress, that was built in the year of 1452. It was a part of a project of conquer, of course, of the Romans. Right after successful capture of the city, the fortress was abandoned because it was lost its purposes, so it's abandoned over the centuries. In fact, it was used as a prison for a while. In the year of 1950.